updated. Hunyuan 3.0. I was waiting for it. But the question is it really worth it? We're gonna figure it out right now. Alright guys, Steph here, and we're gonna review new model Hunyuan 3.0, which is released just yesterday, 16th of September. Well, they dropped the news with this cool trailer showing how they improved the model. The main improvement points is that they have better faces. We'll take a look on that. Precisely reconstruct complex structures, which is nice, and they basically increase the resolution and some crazy 3.6 billion voxels ultra HD modeling for stunning details. Well, sounds amazing, and of course more and more details. Let's see if that's for real. Okay, so just a week ago there was Hunyuan 3D release, and they also do that extremely detailed stuff, and we already tested it, so there will be something to compare with. And I was, by the way, really impressed by those results. You can take a look on the video. Link to the video will be somewhere here. For the benchmarks, we will use same images I used before with 3 levels of details. This one, a little bit simple, female mech bust with a lot of details, especially this small one on the neck, shoulders, and hair, and really, really complex clocks with a lot of details. Additionally, as they claim, the faces are way better right now. We'll first take a look on a face of our Mecha girl. Then we'll do Lego, because I like Lego. There will be a paladin. We'll test a multi-view with him. We'll see how accurate it is. And there will be a Pokemon. Expecting it to be cool. Alright guys, now before we dive into Hunyuan itself, many people ask, like, how do I create references? And that's not a big secret, and I'm happy to share it with you. It's really simple. So first of all, I go to ChatGPT, and here is how I prepared to the video. I will basically drop my thoughts, like that there will be a simple object, like detailed object, ultra detailed object, like, and blah blah blah. There's an update, I want to create a benchmark and stuff, and then it gives me a really nice prompt. If I'm not happy, I can change the subject. If I'm cool, I can just adjust it a little bit manually. Now for images themselves, I have two options mainly. It is either Krea.ai, which is very convenient. You can actually go to an image here. It's relatively cheap and fast. There's most of the popular models are also presented here. Krea, Flux, Nano Banana, ChatGPT Image, one of my favorite. Like Flux and ChatGPT Image, probably the best. You just select the model, drop a prompt here, and it actually gives you like four images, and you just continue like finding what you need, adjusting prompt and so on. Another tool I really appreciate is 3D AI Studio, and basically they are Image Studio. Somehow they have more models than Krea. For example, for most of my recent reference, I used Flux Pro. Like this, you basically go here, set like amount of images, some advanced settings if you want it, generate it, and also really quickly you will have four images to select, or you continue. The cool thing about 3D AI Studio is also that when you like some image, you can actually remove the background right from here, which is very important to do before you use any 3D AI. In Krea, you can either upscale it or do some stuff, but you can't remove the background. In some rare cases, when I need to try a specific new model, I can go to full.ai, and it's also very useful. There's most of the new models are announced here. You can see new, like, but basically for any project you do, like a campaign, image, video, even 3D, and that should be it. All right, back to Hunyuan. Okay, so what do we see here? Now we have a new model here available. So this was the V2.5, and by default we have 3.0. We do have a lot of options to faces. Before, for V2.5, it was a cap. Now we can go up to 1.5 mil, which basically means it will be more precise. We still have multi-view, and we can do geometry and texture in one run or by steps. So the process still looks like this. You basically drop an image. You will have 20 free credits per day, which is really cool for a top class model to give like 20 generations, and you can create multiple accounts if you want. Well, that's definitely a big advantage for a community. So press create instantly, and we're gonna wait. One thing I noticed so far is that this model is actually taking less time than the previous one. The generation are at least twice faster subjectively, because I remember before I was waiting up to 7 to 8 minutes. Right now it feels like it is like 3 to 4 minutes, sometimes even faster. Well, let's start reviewing one by one. All right, so here's our first props, and here we go. Here's the original image, and here is the result. But first of all, I like how it actually understands the materials. So it was in version before, but look, so here we do have this reflection and stuff, but it actually ignores it, and it's like a clean surface. It really makes it like a solid material, so we can add reflection like from the environment, which is nice. And the shape is more clean, We can compare it with 2.5 version, and I was really complaining about this sharp faces, which was really ruining the feeling. But the thing is, it looks nice, but on this example, there is not much progress, right? They fixed this problem, which I believe it was an issue. And if we take a look, yes, it's more accurate, it's more smooth, little bit more detailed, but basically, I would say it's not much of progress. Let's move on. Yeah, guys, this is Mr. Mark again, and we just sent pro subscription for Hunyuan 3.0 to winners from the last video, and more giveaways coming soon. Don't forget to join Discord. I'll be sharing promo codes, giveaways, anything for you, all the cool stuff just for you guys. The next one, a female bust. And here we have a face, and they said like this should be really, really nice faces. They improved them a lot. So far with texture, I wouldn't say it is really that good. Well, the texture at least is not good, but it looks okay. The face look okay. For the details themselves, well, I would not say I was impressed, right? If we take a look on what I created with Hunyuan 3.0, this is impressive. Like, look at the details here. Look at the amount of details here, 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 and how accurate they are. And the hairs, and that they are logical. But here, it's still simplified. And by the way, I want to note, they have same resolution. Basically, what they say is like 1536, which is exactly the same resolution Hunyuan 3.0 use. The eyes is always a problem. Same Hunyuan and same here. But what I noticed that there is an improvement if we ignore the texture. So this is really, really nice. I mean, face look really good if we only look on geometry. So for example, here is how face look in Hunyuan 3.0, and here is how accurate it looks in Hunyuan. So this one is really noticeable, at least in this example. We'll take a look on more examples. But for details themselves, I wouldn't say like much progress. They are a little bit more sharper, right? But they still like melt sometimes. I mean, for example, these tubes, like why are they here? Like why? Like some stuff, like not logical stuff happening here. And if we compare with Hunyuan, like look how sharp they are here, right? Not perfect also here, but subjectively I still think here it is more accurate and detailed and more logical, at least like look at the hair. But this is a good progress, especially I like the face without texture. Next example, our really, really complex steampunk clock. Okay, so here is an example, and well, what I can see compared to V2.5, this new model now mirror it on both sides, right? To remind you, week ago we tested it, it was like this, and we can see if there are any improvements. Well, there are improvements. I can definitely tell it's more accurate, more precise. We can take a look here, and I use the max resolution. And don't get me wrong, for this quality and free, this is amazing. Yes, in my opinion, Hunyuan geometry is way better, but again, like this is the paid one. A generation like this might cost you a lot, like almost $1. Yes, it's sharper, but texture is also not that good. I would say maybe at some degree I like this texture more, but again, like I would probably not use this model because like on the background there's a lot of melted objects. This one looks better in general, but geometry is worse. But Hunyuan is really possible to use without texture if you're going to texture it yourself, because like yeah, the geometry here really, really good. Well, here we can see a lot of problems. Well, it's still better than before. Okay, now let's not be so harsh on Hunyuan. Let's go to characters, right? The characters should be really nice. And yeah, they are. They are. So I created like few examples. There's a Lego man. And you know, it's really good because I provided only front view. And look, it actually created an accurate legs with inside parts. I was actually surprised, like, This one is really good, like it really understands Lego. Probably for a generation like this, the 500,000 polygons is overkill. It didn't try to create a glass here. The cool thing is it actually skipped it in a nice way, right? It's like you can actually create it, like it even keeps the space for the glass, Lego glass, which is really nice. They also suggest like that we can rig it automatically, but that's not really working well. Here's the another example, and here is a probably not successful one because I provided two views. I used multi-view generation. I provided this image and this image, and well, it's a little bit scary. So without texture, actually makes sense, and I use like the highest resolution possible here, but I think the quality of face still depends on overall detailization, right? And I also see the artifact like this, which is strange. It might create a backside of a Lego legs, but failing with this one, which is a little bit strange. Otherwise, it actually follows the backside view and it creates what I provided, but on less quality. And here is my last test. Well, this one I really like. It messed a little bit with the texture on the eyes, but geometry is so sharp and cool that I can actually forgive them, right? So the only thing here I see that I don't like is the eyes. Well, this is just the way texture messed it a little bit, but that's super easy to fix. Other than that, like, it's super cool. This one is a million polygons. Let's take a look. Same generation with 50k, and yes, it actually decreases the resolution. And I mean, geometry is basically the same. It's a little bit more like sort of sharper, edgy, because we have less polygons. But why the texture is way worse? That's the question. And here I also tested the max one. Eyes are a problem. Like in this one, in my last generation on the max, like the eyes are even worse. But lucky for me, one example was really good and I'm happy with the result. Now about the mesh, if we drop it to the blender, what we're gonna see? We're gonna see a very, very dense mesh, very similar to what we saw in Hightem. You see, it's just a lot of polygons. So I don't think like it is worth to say about like the topology in this case. This is just a lot of polygons that require it. Retopology, if you want to use it like in mobile games and so on. By the way, Hunyuan has 3D intelligent topology, which is worth checking, and sometimes you can actually get some decent results. So if you created something really cool, you can try this one. It might really help you, so you can give it a try. Okay, now let me rate it absolutely subjectively. It's good. I really like what they do, but it's not a sensation. It's been almost a year since last update, and I was expecting maybe more, but I can't complain. And get me right here, because this one is free. They give you 20 credits daily, which is 20 generation, and this one is really good for the community, and they do have my biggest appreciation for that. Neither top 3D AI do like that, but the improvement is not big. You know, the funny thing, when I was watching the video and I posted the video on this moment, and I realized like I don't see a big difference in before and after. Yes, the details are sharper, but it's not that significant. But still, good job. And again, you can try it for free right now, so go get it. This is a really cool one. Hope you like the video, and don't forget to subscribe to be the first to know about updates in 3D AI landscape. See ya.